Hello, welcome to Motoring Trends. We have so far seen vehicle manufacturers and the component suppliers. Today, we are going to see a lubricant manufacturer, GP Petroleums Limited. GP Petroleums Limited is a part of GP Global, a $6 billion diversified conglomerate based out of UAE. It is one of the largest players in the petrochemical industry. GP Petroleums Limited, a listed company, ranks among the top 1,000 companies in terms of market capitalization. This company has an exclusive license agreement with Repsol of Spain to manufacture and market its products. We all know Repsol has its association with MotoGP. GP Petroleum's flagship brand, EPOL, is known for its multiple applications. It is currently available in over 10 countries. To tell us more about the company and its prospects, we have with us the CEO of the company, Mr. Prasad Achar. He is going to talk to us on the current scenario in the industry, his company, and future prospects. Welcome, Mr. Achar. Thank you for joining. Over to Mr. Achar's office in Bombay. Thank you. To start with, can you elaborate on your operations in India?
GP Petroleums is a part of the GP Global, an over $6 billion diversified conglomerate headquartered in UAE and is a major player in the petrochemical industry. GPPL is a listed company and ranks amongst the top 1,000 companies in terms of market capitalization. We specialize in formulating, blending and marketing of industrial and automotive lubricants, process oils and other specialties. We have a well-established network of over 500 distributors across the country.
How do you see prospects to expand in the near future?
We expect demand from rural India to jump back quickly, followed by the tier 2 and 3 towns. Our presence is quite strong in these geographies as we had strategically proliferated. The motorcycle space is expected to do well given the drive for social distancing. Repsol is strong in the motorcycle oil space due to its association with MotoGP. In a situation like the current one, the consumers downtrade and we are well poised to capture those who drop off from the super premium segment to premium as well as value for money segments through our dual brands Repsol and EPOL. We are also working on expansion of our distributor network for industrial products. Moving forward, we also see digital integration of our business with the data being the new oil. Digital will drive our expansion plans through channel expansion in automotive and new segment entries in industrial. The new phase will be dominated by mobile apps, for example, and will be deployed across channels. We are driving Salesforce automation and loyalty programs for the mechanic and the trade.
Interesting to know about your digital initiatives that are much warranted in the current scenario. Can you tell us about your investment to set up a blending operations in India?
We currently operate a plant in Vasai near Mumbai with an annual capacity of 80,000 metric tons and a storage facility of 15,000 metric tons, one of the largest in the Indian industry. Earlier this year, we announced setting up of a new blend plant facility in Saronda in Gujarat. The new plant will be a state-of-the-art facility with the capacity to process over 324,000 kiloliters of lubricants and specialty chemicals.
Can you brief us about your research and development activities in India?
In the lubricant industry, the molecular level R&D is the forte of the additive manufacturers. We in GP focus on demonstration of product benefits and unique customer value propositions through our in-house R&D facility. We have successfully developed various synthetic greases, high-performance metalworking fluids, rust preventives and quenchants. We are associated with the test houses like AVL, ARAI, ICAT for the product performance studies for the automotive lubricants. Also, GPPL has a memorandum of understanding signed with the Institute of Chemical Technology, Mumbai, for the research and development in the area of high-performance components development for the lubricants.
Oh, that's a lot in your research portfolio. What are your short-term and long-term plans?
For us at GPPL, customer centricity is driven by our passion to deliver to the last mile. Even during the current lockdown, we were amongst the first few who had resumed operations as per government guidelines in mid-April itself. And we have already progressed from survival to revival phase. We aligned the whole organization to a single focus on cost and cash flow management titled Tank to Bank Velocity. In the second phase, the focus is on responsible sales and customer centricity in these difficult times. Plus, the new facility in Saronda, introduction of new global brands in India, will bring in targeted business growth. In the post-COVID-19 era, we are hopeful that we will achieve our long-term growth plan via both organic and inorganic routes and be the lead contributor towards our group's mission to emerge as a 500 million liters business globally.
Thank you so much, Mr. Acharya, for talking to Motoring Trends, sparing your valuable time. Thank you so much.